You know, the last time I had a conversation with Exodus, the feedback, someone said, Mary, why is he answering questions with questions? Something is fishy. Something is not right. Something is going on. He needs to tell us more. Yo, there was too much fire. Social media was buzzing. Everybody was talking about Exodus and this chat he had on Salon Talk with Mary Luswata. It was too much. I have brought Exodus back here. And we're going to get into it, a lot more of it. But of course, there's a conversation that's been pending. I don't know if Obana Sunako the last time, but you remember when I told you about women these days, and when you watch TV and all you see is, oh my God, I have got this thing in a bottle. It will help you get more, to put it plainly, water. Yeah, and then the guys, oh, the men, we will help you. You know, you can hang a towel on it. That's strong. There's just too much buzz about sexual enhancements. It's everywhere, and people are making a killing off it. You are buying. Everybody's buying this stuff. Is it this intense in the bedroom? Every woman wants to spice up their sex life. So you see where I'm going with this. This conversation is going to be so much fire. You need to be a part of it. Use the hashtag Salon Talk. My name is Mary Luswata. Welcome to the show. I'm at the beautiful Spectre Salon and Spa in Bugolobi. I love this place. It makes me feel like a woman. Hey, if your weave is falling out, come here. Let's fix you up. If your nails are chipped, if you need a spa treatment, if you need your kids to come and have some time, please come to Spectre Salon in Bugolobi and have the best treatment ever. Exodus.
Yes, my dear.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Let me tell you something.
Tell me.
I have never had a show. Well, I just started doing this show, but I've never had a show where everybody was asking, Kati, Chechigena Maso, is he single? I kept on telling them, don't worry. He'll be back on the show. Are you single? Let's first start there. Are you single?
When the right person comes in my life, I'll definitely let it out still. Yeah, but at the moment, I'm more focused on ambition, bettering myself as a person, you know, and my music, basically.
Spoken like a real single man. You got your answer. You have your answer. Hit him up. His inbox, his DM. Muche maride. Nzemba wade answer. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I know you. Yes, mm-hmm. I know you. Mm-hmm. Okay, first introduce yourself and then I'll know if I am wrong or not.
I'm Nabunya Stella. Mm-hmm. I'm an accountant. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and a mother of one.
Your mother, yay! You're back.
I'm back.
People have been asking for your services. Abi, where can I find him? How can I get in touch with him? That man will transform my social life. He'll transform my own life. If you're watching the show for the first time, this gentleman is going to introduce himself and you're going to need his services. I can guarantee you. Introduce yourself.
Yes, Isaac. I'm a marketing manager, a general manager, and a business development manager.
I told you, you'll need his services. Exodus.
Yes, my dear.
Is there anything you want to tell me?
If there is anything you want to ask me.
Why do you answer questions with... Somebody said, why does Exodus answer questions with questions? What are you trying to hide?
It's the street in me. I'm not trying to hide anything.
You're not trying to hide anything?
No. It's the wall street in me. I'm not just trying to hide anything.
Yeah. Do you have two sons or three babies?
Like I told you the other time, yeah? I think we just got it off on the wrong... people just got it off on the wrong place.
Go up, you'll get up.
Auntie, now remember, I have two boys and a baby.
What is the baby? Is the baby a boy?
But he's still he's barely a year, so he's still a very little kid.
Exodus, yeah. Do you have three sons? With your ex-wife?
I have three little boys. Three amazing boys.
Thank you. Children. Do you think your kids are going to be proud of you if you're living separately from their mother?
People meet and people separate. That's the way of life, you understand? That's something you can't change, you understand? I am not God. I'm human, very human, you understand? If something does not work out, I believe it's better you live happily separated than to fight together.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm.
Yeah, because you've heard a lot of things where people have gone overboard killing other people. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying it is what is happening or what happens, but I believe you're better happy separated than to fight together. You
How often do you see the boys?
I see them every weekend.
Every weekend?
Yes.
Why not every day?
The hustle. Because of the hustle. So I get to have my kids on the weekends. And they have to be in school Monday to Friday, you understand? And daddy is hustling here and there, trying to put things together so that they can be happy. They can, you know, they can be happy. Yeah.
Let me ask you a question. All this drama that went on in the tabloids, did it have anything to do with your separation? Did she say, you know what?
Which drama?
You and... I don't want to go back. We did that last week. Mm. This week we want to dive into
but
something
Nancy,
else.
You ask, Nziramuntu ya chesimanyi. I have to answer what I know. So if you say drama, which drama? There is alcohol drama, there is women drama, there is a lot of controversies.
Get all that so, drama and mix it together. Make a cocktail.
Auntie Kakati, Mary, it is you asking me. It is not me asking you.
We are having a conversation.
Exactly, but it's you asking the question.
What so, you said, alcohol drama, women drama, you've answered the question. Don't worry.
You're crazy.
Don't worry about it. So anyway, guys, please join our conversation on our social media. Mine is at Taswalu and...
Nabunya Stella.
Isaac Odong Senior.
And Exodus UG.
Exodus UG.
Yes.
Everywhere.
Tag us in all your comments, your tweets, your sub-tweets, your replies. Let's get this conversation going, yeah? Now, have you watched TV and seen this Senga Okoja? And he's promising to make your bedroom life better. Much, much, much better than what it is right now. First of all, the first question that I ask myself is that has intimacy become this... Okay, well, it has always been important, but where does the pressure come from? Where does the intimate pressure come from? I thought it's supposed to be very easy. You meet someone, you like them. When you fall in love with somebody, everything's supposed to flow naturally.
As in, the whole thing is that men and women, there's a competition. Women are saying we are very many and men are few. So the fight is that I want this man, I want this one. So you have to fight and get a way of getting him better or making him good at sex, making him that whole drama.
You have to bring your game. It's too much work. It's just too much work. It's too much work that these women are making so much money. Exodus, is it competition? Has it become a competition in the bedroom?
I don't think it's competition. Two things. Social media has changed a lot of things about life. And second, I believe, you understand, I'll go back old school. When you meet, say, a man, when you meet a woman, you understand, there's certain things that strike you about that woman, you understand. And then you get together, you get to work together, it's beautiful, it's amazing. But in the long run, things become shaky. You understand? Things
Why?
Because I believe omukazi bwa musanga na kukuba waita wakasera ebintu ebyo nabyerabira.
Atia. Not the Twitter bira.
No, like
oh, we don't forget.
Listen,
we don't forget to bring it.
The swata, you know what I'm talking about. You meet a woman, yeah? You meet a woman. Now like me, I love small women. You meet a woman, she's small, she's beautiful and all that, you understand? And then when you get together, probably then she gets to get the feeling of I own him now.
Comfortable.
She relaxes.
She gets comfortable.
When I met you, you used to go to gym. You don't go to gym anymore. When I met you, you used to wear lingerie. You don't wear lingerie anymore. When I met you, you used to look a certain way. You used to make me feel like, wow, I got the queen. You understand? And after time, these things are not happening anymore. You understand? And then there's a dispatch. You know, there's a... That intimacy,
but things,
separation.
But things are supposed to change. You don't have babies and things stay the same.
No. Things are not supposed to change. You understand? If I am not changing, why are you changing?
Because you're not the one bringing the...
My dear.
You are mother.
My dear.
How does it change?
We are all working together. Look at J-Lo. Look at J-Lo. How many children does she have?
Please don't bring
J-Lo. No, I have to.
But do you know what? How many children does she have? Do you know what? When I give birth, get a baby... You're supposed to also keep me in the form. Like, tell me, go to the gym, keep me there. But you want to
remind me.
Remind
me, because now I'm sharing you with somebody who needs 100% attention.
Some women don't take that seriously. Like, you would tell her and she's like, you're just bothering me. Why are you telling me this? So you mean I look bad now? You mean you understand all those things? You understand? So, but
Isaac, do things change in the bedroom spark. After a long time? Where does the spark go? Why are women to blame for the loss of the spark?
I would term it as sexual naivety.
Hey,
all of us have that.
There's
problem.
A new word.
You can call it naivety, you can call it frigidity, whatever. We have been educated to a point that, yes, I'm a man, I'm supposed to hunt for a woman. Mm. Yes, she's supposed to come towards me.
Yes.
But what most people forget is that even after you've lured this woman into your relationship, you still have
you keep
to
the work.
Attract her. Like you've just met her for the first time.
You agree?
That is also true in marriage or when she has given birth. You continue nurturing her. Call her every day. Check on her. Most men will tell you after she has given birth, what am I looking for? She has a bowel there. I'm not going to look after her right now. Yes, it is true.
Ouch.
But, I mean, there are people who actually go ahead and say, no, I oyo kavera kati, you get.
Oh, my God.
But, I mean, give her time. And you see, I'll also blame the churches for this. They know, well, November, October, she's about to give birth. January, February, so what do? They start preaching about how a man should first stay away from a woman during that time. So there are so many things that are playing into your head at this
point. So many factors.
But what I'm looking for is, how do I continue looking at this woman, appreciating her? People say the spark has gone. The spark hasn't gone.
It can never go.
It is you who
it
is supposed to
It can't go to keep
spark.
It burning. Yes.
Why? Because if you give this person the attention they need, the communication they need, you wake up every day and say, honey, you know what, you're looking beautiful. Even after having sex with her for a week, she's going to stay there.
It's a two-way traffic. Just like you said it, the opposite is also true. The reverse is true. Yeah. You understand?
So you know what? We'll start there.
If you don't work it in, definitely the spark is going to disappear.
Okay, we'll start there. It's a two-way traffic. You have to keep working as a woman as he keeps working as a man. We'll be right back.